Hello and Chanukah Sameach. I want to share with you some thoughts from the heart, some ideas that I've been grappling with and thinking about this Chanukah. I think the fundamental question is, what does Chanukah demand of us this year in Tavshin Pei Bet, 2021? Let's turn to the Gemara in Masechet Shabbat, Daf Kaf Aleph Amud Bet. This is the primary Gemara that discusses Chanukah. And we ask, how does one fulfill the mitzvah of lighting the candles? And we know there's a famous idea. There are three different levels. Ner Ishu Veito, everyone should just light one candle each night. There's a higher level, Mehadrin, where you light more candles. And then Mehadrin, Mina Mehadrin, which according to the Rambam means that everyone in the family lights their own Chanukiah in the ascending order of one on the first night all the way up to eight on the last night. It's very clear in the Gemara, three different levels. There's a machloket exactly what the details are between the Rishonim, the Rambam, and the Tosfot, and the Shulchan Aruch, and the Rambam, but everyone agrees there are three levels. However, when you take a look at the Shulchan Aruch, when he codifies this halacha, the Shulchan Aruch makes no mention of these three levels. The Shulchan Aruch just says, Kama Neirot Madlik, and immediately quotes the highest level, Mehadrin Mina Mehadrin. What is the Shulchan Aruch teaching us? I think there's a very important lesson here. And that is that Chanukah is about religious maximalism. The norm on Chanukah is about doing the most. The basic level becomes, the highest level becomes the basic level. Why is this the case? We do this because Chanukah was a celebration of the fact that Antiochus and the Yevanim wanted to destroy Judaism. They wanted to eradicate Judaism from the face of the earth. And so what do? We go above and beyond. We pursue religious maximalism, and we make that our basic practice on Chanukah. There's no Mahadrin Mina Mahadrin. Mahadrin Mina Mahadrin becomes the most basic fulfillment of the mitzvah of Hadakat Neirot. We fight against the Yevanim by doing more, not by doing less, by doing more. And it's interesting, is Chanukah a political victory, or is it really a religious victory? And the truth is, it's both. We, as those who are, you know, believe in Reshit Smichat Gulatenu, we thank HaKadosh Baruch Hu for Medinat Yisrael, and we see the Hasmonean state that was created 2,000 years ago as another iteration of that, another example of Jewish sovereignty, and so we celebrate that today. But we must never forget that Chanukah is also a religious struggle. It was about the Jews fighting against the Greeks. And the way that we celebrate that is by doing more, by making Mahadrin Mina Mahadrin into our basic Jewish practice. Now, in today's day and age, especially in COVID times, we sometimes, instead of pursuing religious maximalism, we fall into the lowest common denominator Judaism. Whatever is convenient, whatever is comfortable, whatever is easy. If we could just roll out of bed in our pajamas and go to shul, we would actually do that. And we just want things to be on our own terms. We shouldn't be pushed too hard. We shouldn't be challenged too much. We just want things to be efficient. That's the key term. Everything has to be efficient and easy. And so here we have two different models. Religious maximalism as represented by Chanukah. And what's happened today in our world, and this is throughout the Jewish world, of comfortability, convenience, lowest common denominator Judaism. And I believe that this Chanukah, we need to strive for more. We need to pursue excellence, not mediocrity, not average. In every other area of life, do we pursue mediocrity? Does someone on an average salary or an average grade on a test? We pursue excellence in every area of life. We want to be in the best units in the army. We want to have the best, the highest salary. We want to go on the best vacation. Let's pursue excellence. Let's pursue religious maximalism in our Yahadut, in our Avodat Hashem. I want to encourage everybody here. Take on a little extra this chag. If it's learning some Torah, if it's attending an extra minyan, if it's doing more chesed, giving more tzedakah, whatever it is, doing daf yomi, pick one thing, just one thing, and do it a little bit more. Let the light of the Chanukiah shine as we light more and more candles, but also let our ma'asim, our deeds, also spread the light of religious maximalism, of fighting the Yevanim in our day and age. Wishing you all an amazing, amazing Chag. And Be'ezrat Hashem, we should bring more light to the world. Chag Urim Sameach.